Good morning, dear students. Let us start the class with Brahmanad. Om. Om. Before going to discuss today's lesson, I would like to introduce the topic. As we are all Indians, let us know some of the names of Indian leaders who made our country proud. So, looking at the photograph, can you tell me who is this man? Yes, he is Mahatma Gandhi, a well-known photograph of our country. He is the great leader of our country. In his leadership, we got freedom for our country. Look at the next photograph. Who is this person? Yes, he is Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, born on 14th November, and he was the first Prime Minister of India from 1947 to 1964. Look at the next photograph, a well-known photograph, very popular among you all. Yes, he is Subhash Chandra Bose. He is known as Netaji and he is well known for his patriotism, and he said, give me blood, I would give you freedom, and the whole country was quite eager to get freedom under his leadership. Look at the next photograph. Who is he? He is Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, and he was the first Vice President of India and second President of India from 1962 to 1967. We observe Guru Divas on his birthday. What is the date? Recently we observed 5th November. Very good. Next photograph. Who is he? Yes, he is B.R. Ambedkar. Bhim Rao Ramji Ambedkar. He is popular among all of us because he had written the Constitution of India, and he was born on 14th April 1891 and died on 6th December 1956. Okay, now look at the photograph. Who is he? Do you know him? Yes. He is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, and he is known as the Missile Man of India, and we are going to read more about him. Let us see the book and we will read about Dr. APJ Kalam. Abul Fakir Jainulabuddin Abdul Kalam, better known as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, was one of the most distinguished scientists of India. As he was intimately involved in India's civilian space program and military missile development efforts, He came to be known as the Missile Man of India. In 2002, he was elected as the 11th President of India and was widely referred to as the People's President. Dr. Abdul Kalam was born on 15 October 1931 in a Tamil Muslim family at Rameswaram in the state of Tamil Nadu. His father, Jainul Abidin, was a boat owner and the imam of a local mosque. His mother, Asiyama, was a housewife. His father owned a ferry that took Hindu pilgrims back and forth between Rameswaram and Dhanushkodi. Kalam was the youngest of four brothers and one sister in his family. His ancestors had been wealthy traders and landowners, but in course of time, the family fell on hard times and lost their properties, even their ancestral home. By his early childhood, the family had already become poor. Kalam had to sell newspapers to supplement his family's income. Now, you are all advised to read the portion, first and second paragraph, silently once. Very good. From the first and second paragraph, I have collected some of the difficult words for you. Look at the difficult words and let us discuss the meanings of difficult words here. Distinguish, adjective used, very successful and admired by people or praised by people. Intimately, adverb used, means closely, my friend, intimately involved in my personal problem. Involved, verb, concerned or taking part. Civilian, noun use, not related to armed force. Missile, a weapon that is sent through the air and that explodes when it hits the thing it is aimed at. Widely referred to means popularly known. Imam, noun use, a religious man or person who leads the prayer in a mosque. Ferry, renown, a boat that carries people. Another word you see, to and fro. To and fro means to go and return back. To go and return back. Pilgrim, noun form, a person who travels to a holy place for religious purpose. Ancestors, noun form, a person in a family who lived long time ago. Ancestral, adjective used, belonging to people older than grandparents. Trader, noun used, a person who buys and sells things as a job. In course of time, over a period of time. Supplement, to add something to something, to improve. This is all about the meanings collected from the first and second point of the lesson, the missile man of India, I would advise you now to read the first and second point silently once. Very good. Now, be attentive and listen to both the points in detail. Abul Pakir Zainulabuddin Abdul Kalam, better known as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, was one of the most distinguished scientists of India. Most of the APJ Abdul Kalam was most of the renowned scientist and popular scientists of India. As he was intimately involved in India's civilian space program and military missile development efforts, he came to be known as the missile man of India. He was not only involved in India's civilian space program, not related to armed force, civilian space program, as well as military missile development efforts. So he came to be known as the missile man of India. In 2002, he was elected as the 11th president of India and was widely referred to as the people's president. In 2002, he was elected as the 11th president of our country, India, and he was popularly known as people's president, as he was liked very much by the people. Dr. Abdul Kalam was born on 15th October 1931 in a Tamil Muslim family at Rameswaram in the state of Tamil Nadu. Very simple. At Rameswaram in the state of Tamil Nadu, Abdul Kalam was born on 15th October 1931 in a Tamil Muslim family. His father Zainulabuddin was a boat owner and the imam of a local mosque. His father, means Abdul Kalam's father Zainulabuddin, was imam of a local mosque, and his mother Asiyama was a housewife. Abdul Kalam's mother Asiyama was only a housewife. His father owned a ferry that took Hindu pilgrims back and forth between Rameswaram and Dhanushkodi. His father owned a ferry, means he had a ferry of his boat of his own, and in which he took Hindu pilgrims back and forth, to and fro, from Rameswaram to Dhanushkodi. Kalam was the youngest of four brothers and one sister in his family. Kalam was the youngest of four brothers and one sister. Out of all the five siblings, Kalam was the youngest one. He was the youngest of four brothers and one sister. His ancestors had been wealthy traders and landowners, but in course of time the family fell on hard times and lost their properties, even their ancestral home. His ancestors were wealthy traders and landowners. They owned their landed property. Wealthy traders, rich traders and landowners, they had land of their own. But in course of time, as time went by, they lost all their properties, even their ancestral home. By his early childhood, the family had already become poor. Kalam had to sell newspapers to supplement his family's income. In his early childhood, the family had already become poor. Kalam's family had already become poor, and Kalam had to sell newspapers to add some income to his family. This is all about the first and second paragraph or point of the lesson, The Missile Man of India. I have collected some of the questions I would like to ask you some of the questions from first and second point. Who was Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam? Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was one of the most distinguished scientists and the 11th president of India. Why was he known as the Missile Man of India? Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was known as the Missile Man of India for his involvement in civilian space program as well as in military missile development efforts. When was he elected as the 11th president? Kalam was elected as the 11th president in the year 2002. This is all about the lesson today. We will meet in the next class to discuss about the other points of the lesson. Thank you very much.